Disappearances and killings happen around the world at a blink's notice. Although most come with a rational explanation of the events that transpired, some are shrouded with more mystery. Today, we take a dive into the unknown and dig deeper into some of these cases that left us with more questions than answers, such as the Kinross disappearance in 1953. It all started when unusual aircrafts were appearing in restricted areas, even seeming to follow some pilots. One pilot in 1953 decided to pursue a UFO that appeared in the restricted area over Lake Superior. After further pursuance by the pilot, eventually the Air Force couldn't track their craft anymore, and it was established as missing. This incident is called the Kinross disappearance, and many believe that the pilot was attacked or taken by the flying saucer. To go into more detail, the Kinross Air Force Base had dispatched pilot Lieutenant Felix Eugene Moncla Jr. and radar operator Lieutenant Robert L. Wilson to keep a lookout over the base. Wilson went to investigate the foreign aircraft that was seen in the restricted area over Lake Superior and Lake Huron. Flying in a U.S. Air Force F-89C, they encountered the aircraft when both of their blips, displaying their location, merged on radar. Thinking that they flew under or over the unidentified aircraft, the operator from the Air Force became alarmed when he noticed that the F-89 did not appear on the radar again. Although the blip of the unidentified aircraft appeared again, only to quickly veer off and vanish. Resultantly, a search and rescue mission was created to search for the pilot and operator aboard the F-89, fearing there might have been a crash. According to an Air Force missing report dating back to 1953, a, quote, search for the missing aircraft was conducted by both the USAF and RCAF aircraft without success, end quote. Trying to cover as much of the location as possible, a, quote, 80% area coverage was reported, end quote. Sadly, not much land was able to be covered due to heavy snow that was reported that night. Resultantly, due to these unfortunate circumstances, the two men and their F-89C were never found. Oddly, the weather that day was noted to be nice with fairly scattered clouds and the air was stable with little turbulence. Following that, even if there was bad weather, the plane was meant to handle low visibility. The pilot was also experienced with a recording flying time of 1,120 hours. Therefore, many started to believe outside factors, like the UFO, caused the crash or kidnapped them. In fact, the public had several extraterrestrial theories regarding the missing plane and those aboard. One theory was that the plane crashed into the UFO's protective beam, like a solid barrier. The second theory was that the jet was grabbed out of the air and taken inside of the spacecraft to be researched. Although many tried to discredit these theories by claiming they found plane parts by the lake, none of these claims were ever verified. Later, Air Force officials released a statement about the incident saying that the plane, quote, was followed by radar until it merged with an object, end quote. However, they later changed their story completely, denying that the plane had merged with anything. They claimed the unknown aircraft was a Royal Canadian aircraft that had accidentally lost course, but the Canadian Air Force denied those claims. Their next claim was that the plane crashed due to the pilot's episodes of horrific vertigo, but they were unable to dig up evidence to support that. Ultimately, their statements weren't matching up, and it appeared they were pulling on straws. Trying to solve the missing pieces of the story, they weren't able to persuade people that extraterrestrial creatures weren't at fault. Following that, investigators from the NICAP, National Investigations Committee on Aerial Phenomenon, started to dig into the disappearance. they discovered that the mission was completely kept out of official records. Suspicious of officials trying to hide the Kinross disappearance from the public's eye, they released a statement regarding their findings. Their official statement said, quote, "There is no record in the Air Force files of sighting at Kinross AFB on 23rd November 1953. There is no case in the files which even closely parallels these circumstances," end quote. However, even though the Air Force officials' changing stories were suspicious, it's important to note that the F-89C had structural problems that could have caused the crash. First of all, issues with the engine persisted even though it was a newer model. In addition, constructional issues were found regarding the wings. In spite of that fact, though, the way that the Air Force officials treated the case caused red flags, even signaling a cover-up. For example, although several pilots had stated they saw UFOs in the area, documentation was never submitted to the Blue Book files. On top of that, the Kinross disappearance was suspiciously deleted from the files, minimizing the coverage of the case. Overall, it must be said that the Kinross disappearance was a very strange case and still doesn't have a hard conclusion to the events that transpired. In fact, the missing plane, the pilot, and the operator still haven't been found. With the evidence shown, is it a cover-up to something bigger and unheard of? Hey guys, I hope you enjoyed the video and I'd love to hear what you think in the comments below. If you enjoy my videos, please feel free to hit the subscribe button and turn post notifications on so you don't miss the next upload from me. Stay safe, and I hope you aren't too paranoid next time you get on a plane. Good night!